It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Magic Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
He's back.
I'm back.
Here
yes,
I am.
He's back. First, we are going to have, we've not done the normal thing where we kind of look through something, watch all the tutorials and chat over breakfast. This, I've just insisted that I perform it on the guys.
Yes.
They don't know what this is, but I will tell you what it is. It's Bazaar de Magia, hands off, The Perfect Chest. It's their latest incarnation of something that was around about 20 years ago, but it is a lockbox. It is a safe box, and you can check it out, Wayne. It is secure. Secure, it's locked up, right?
It really is locked up,
and
yeah.
That's because I've got the keys here. There's one, two...
Oh, a few keys.
Three...
Or just one.
Four keys. And Wayne, try and show it towards the camera like this.
Okay, mate.
Pick up any one of the keys. Try it in the lock. And from now on, I will not touch the box or the lock. Put it in. Is it gone all the way in?
It has gone all the way in.
Right. Make sure it's all the way in. That's it. Put it all the way in. Did it open the box?
No.
No.
Ooh.
Right. So this is the safe box. There we go. And try another key. I don't want to touch these keys. I'm not going to touch it because it is Bazaar de Magia's hands off.
Hands off.
Hands off.
I get what's going on now. It's hands off.
He's not opening it.
He's not opening it.
What a disappointment.
Right. Okay. Try the next one.
I will.
Right. So This is three out of three. One more. Three out of four. One key left.
Very, very disappointing.
Try it. Have you won the prize? Do you know why?
Why?
Because the real key is in here.
That's not fair, is it?
Rude.
This is crazy.
Like
right, this rude. Is the key yep. that I keep in this box.
That box.
That opens the chest.
Okay.
So check it out. Open it. There you go.
It's open.
Right, take the key out. I don't want to touch it. Right. Sorry. We're going to lock the box again in a moment. But first of all, can you take your phone out?
Oh, no.
And yes. Sean's phone's over there
I'm
as well.
I'm obsessive about my
Sean's
phone.
Sean's phone's over there.
Here it is.
Right. Put it in the box. Put it in the box. Right. And you've got the key in there ready to lock it again.
Close
it down. Right, lock the box. Right, I put that key with the other four, so there's five keys.
Well, you can still see it's that one.
Yeah.
It's that one.
Right,
yeah, mate.
Now,
I'll put it with that. I'll put it with the rest of the keys. that's where I'm putting it.
There you go.
Now you've got to mix them. Mix them around. Come on. No, really mix them.
Put with the box and shake them.
No, give them a mix.
Give them a mix.
You don't think it's a trick box. Ah, right. Right, I'm going to look away now. I'm not going to look.
Okay.
Right.
I'm shaking my maracas.
This is what I need you to do, right? Mm. Wayne, you're going to take full responsibility. I'm not looking because it's hands off.
Right.
Choose one key. Don't do anything with it yet, though. Just take one key. Decide on one key.
And now eat it.
Have you got a key?
Yes.
Right, put that key to one side. That's the key we're going to use. Mm-hmm. Have you done it?
Yeah.
Right, all the other four keys,
yeah.
What I want you to do now is put them in the slot in the top of the box.
No.
Do it. What do you mean? Just do it. That's
one,
it.
Two, three.
Have you done it?
Four.
Yeah. You put them in the slot in the top of the box. Okay. So have you got one key now? Just one key?
No.
Yeah. Hold on to that one key you've kept separate.
Yeah.
Right? I'm turning back around. Now remember, right, you decided on this key.
Yes.
You've eliminated the...
You said put them in the strong box.
No, I said put them in the slot in the top of the box.
Yeah, that. That's the slot in the top
of the box. This box.
Yeah.
I meant this box. The slot in the top of the box.
Go and get the welding torch.
No, I showed you that box with the slot.
No.
So that was the...
It's, well,
you put them in there.
You better hope that...
But you've locked it.
Yeah. Mm.
And I haven't touched the box.
You haven't touched the box.
He's not touched it.
Wait, I hope this has worked. And
so
you
do I.
have used your mind-reading powers to choose the correct key, which I have not touched.
You ain't touched it.
Put it in the lock. Oh,
dear, oh goodness.
Where's the phone gone? Thanks, mate.
Right, we will now pause the video and I'll show the guys how this works and then we'll have a chat about it. The guys have now had a look at the workings,
yep.
Seen how it works. It was out before, a wooden version, and they go through the history on the tutorial that's about 30 minutes long. You get a performance. The performance that's on there is a bit more sort of serious mentalism where they each pick a key and the mentalist defines which key will open the box and he takes more of the credit for it. But the difference with this version is it is totally hands-off. The original perfect chess from Bazaar de Magia, you had to interact with the chess. You had to actually touch it at some point. You don't need to do that. But you see how it works, guys? I know what I think already because I've had a few days to play with this device. What do you think, Wayne?
I was pleasantly surprised because normally this kind of thing I'm not that bothered about because nearly always they're made terrible. But this is made lovely. It's really heavy. It's a chunky bit of kit made out of metal and the method is very good. I like the way this.
The idea. Yeah, I had this idea.
That's the David Penn idea.
Come on, I'm claiming that. Yeah, you can that, use it though.
Yeah, put that on there. That
and then
that was
have
good.
That jeopardy
that
where... they've put it in the wrong box.
Yeah, that was a lovely, lovely moment. If you're looking for a bit
you need
of
to make that
comedy,
better,
yeah,
though.
You need to. Yeah, no, I think it's done nice, mate. I think honestly, I would possibly perform it without the comedy, though. I think that's quite an in-depth thing. If you had some, you know, you added a person with a key, they put some kind of message out there with it as well. And they've held onto it for ages. You could milk it for a lot, but the point of it is. Actually really easy to operate as
well. Yeah, it works by itself.
It really does.
I like it better than the wooden one, so the wooden one might be a magic prop.
Yeah.
I've got one of these at home. A lot of people have got these at home.
Where? Where do you keep it? I come round yours every now and then.
Yeah.
Where is it?
But people are used to seeing these. It looks normal. It's easy to operate. And I think anybody that performs magic with a borrowed mobile phone has now got an extra four... Do you know anybody, Dave?
No.
No. You've now got an extra 5-minute bit, which you can perform seriously like Wayne, or you can perform comedy like Dave's idea, and you've got something brilliant that leads into any piece of mobile phone magic.
You know, going into a chair test, you've got four people on stage, and you're all going to do something, you're going to get you used to it, and they all put their phones in, and then it leads into like a chair test style presentation. Yeah. But you've got the four, I reckon you get about six phones in there quite easily if you wanted to, and it is people's most valuable possession. And you could do it. You could actually do it table hopping and take everybody's phone
at
the table.
Yeah.
I can't wait to hear that of the teenagers. Right, Beth,
you see
phone.
You later.
Jack, Chelsea, get your phones in.
It is made really well. I really like this. I know I'm going to use it. I know I'm going to come up with a routine for it. That idea of the jeopardy that they've put it in the wrong box... that needs scripting even better. Mm. But the core idea is there for me. I'm giving this 95%. Wayne.
Wow. I'm not going to do it. That doesn't take away from the fact that it is a brilliant, brilliant prop. I'm going to give it 89%.
Even though it's not a card trick, I like it. And I think it would be used as a lead in into something.
Are you going to get everyone to put their decks of cards in
there? Well, I do use mobile phones and cards at the same time.
Yeah,
so it's a lead in into something. So...
91%. Wow,
it's a hit. It's a hit. It's a really great prop. It's not cheap. It's about £250, but you are getting a quality product that works itself and you can focus on your routine, be it comedy, be it serious. Ooh. Over to Wayne Fox.
Let me show you some magic.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Can I borrow a coin? That one.
not set up there. In any way.
That's the coin we're going to borrow. Can I borrow a pen?
Camera pen.
Have you got one?
Yep.
You got one? Solid and stretch. Available for
a proper one.
Yes, please. Yeah.
Okay. I'm winding you up. Yeah.
Thank you.
All available from World Magic Shop. Solid and stretch. Google it.
Story of my life.
Get them in the shop, ready for the day. All available. What would you like me to do, Mr. Fox?
Just write something on there, mate. Put your initials on there or something.
The pen's very heavy. I don't know what's going on. Right, let me use David Penn.
Look at that. .co.uk. There it is.
That is signed. Immortalised on camera forever. There we go. Got it.
Okay. And also, David.
David.
Yeah. Very cool. Again, official. What's going on? Have you two had a falling out? What's happened?
Would you like me to do?
I'm going to get you to hold the coin in there. Can you feel it? Grab it. Don't drop
it. I can. I've got it.
You got it, yeah? Hold it up so everyone can see it.
I've got it.
I've also got something
camera.
Else in here that I need you to see.
Yeah.
I'll put it on there. Now, I'm going to take the corner. And Sean, could you take a corner?
This one?
Right, okay.
And we're going to pull this...
Look at
it goes. Yeah, look at this. Look at this going on. And we're just going to pull it apart and pull it out of David's hands.
Which way?
Careful. Just pull it downward.
One, two,
three.
Oh.
It's gone. Right, fuck everybody.
Thank you very much.
All right. Box. On the table.
Yes.
It is on the table. Like a patter.
Did you write this yourself?
Box.
Elastic band.
On the table.
Elastic band, round box.
Elastic band, round box.
Let's take the bands off.
Take the band off box.
Go on. And you can see that it's completely sealed.
Yeah.
Take the bands off and the lid will lift off now.
Right.
And inside...
Oh no!
Another box.
I'm doing this live.
There's 45 in the set.
Yeah.
Right, here we go. Let's put that on there. There we go. Shall I keep going?
Yeah, go on. Why
right,
not?
Here we go.
God. Take that off.
How many elastic bands has this been sealed?
Guess what's inside there?
A sandwich.
Yep.
Another box. There we go.
Take the bands off there, Sean.
Guess what's inside?
Another box!
Another box! Of course it is! Oh!
There's not another box.
A bag!
Come on, Wayne, perform it.
Okay. Let's tip this out.
Yeah.
Little bag. Not even touching it. I'll let you do it. Go for it. Open up that bag.
Huh? My coin.
Yeah. Take the band off the top. It's also even the bag
sealed.
Is sealed.
Wow.
Even the bag is sealed. Tip it out.
Oh!
With your name in it and everything. Wayne Fox, ladies and gentlemen. There you go. Incredible. And very good. I like it.
It's very well made.
Yeah. Very well
made. You've got to say that it is very well made.
Mm.
You had some concerns about it, didn't you, Wayne? Noise-wise.
Yeah. I did. But after actually using it and performing it in front of you guys, you kind of sort of made me realise that I'm sort of worrying about nothing really.
Yeah, because if you're going to your prop box to get the box out and get other stuff done, at the moment you've got to affect the move, that you're going to have noise. And in a room, not like a studio like this, like you did it in the restaurant, you were like, guys, I'm really concerned about how noisy this is. And then you did it, and we were like...
And we did it. And
so, okay.
In a well-constructed routine, at that point, when you're introducing the box, the spectators are holding the coin.
Yes.
Right? Yes. Or it's in view or whatever. Yeah. So there's no heat at that moment where the box is introduced.
Mm.
So
as well as this that you can see on screen, you can see it close up on the camera, so you can see the quality of everything that you're getting with the 4D box. It is available from... Bondly Magic,
yes.
Magic and Mentalism Store.
Yeah, store, yeah.
You got it directly from Bond at the Blackpool Magic Convention.
Yeah.
But you got this, didn't you, Wayne? You know, what do you think of it?
You know what? I have to say, first of all, it's just, it's so well made. It is so well made. It is going to last for a very long time. And if you look after it, possibly forever. I love the way everything fits in.
The way everything's set as well, so that the bands go on there.
Yeah. You've got to...
How long does it take to reset? How long do you reset on it? You've got to once put bands on everything.
You have. And it does have to go round a certain way. To make sure, because when I first started doing it, I was thinking, why isn't this working? I have one of the boxes around the wrong way. So the ridge is in there and the bands go inside. Yeah. It took me kind of like about 3 or 4 minutes.
3 or 4 minutes each time to reset it.
Yeah, it's not
what do you think of it, Sean? And how much are you going to give it?
I really like I like it. I think it suits parlour for me more than close-up. It's not something that I would perform because I did something similar with cards. But I'm going to give it 87%. I think it's very well made, and I think it deserves a place in somebody's act, for sure. Mm,
definitely.
87. Is it wood, or is it like a resin or something?
No, it's wood. It's wood.
It's wood. It's nicely
made. When I got it,
I don't like this version of it particularly, and the method for getting in. It's meant for a folded card as well, isn't it? The folded card's very tricky.
I found that you have got to have a perfect folded card to get it to
but coins,
to load.
No problem.
Coins.
Right, I'm going to give it 78%.
Okay. I've used it. I have now used it, and you have changed my mind about this. The noise, it doesn't matter, but I think it will fit into a routine. I do have something else. It's not changed my mind about the routine that I'm using it with, but I do... Yeah, you've changed your mind about the noise thing. I'm going to give it 89%.
89%. Yeah, it's a lovely made thing. You've got nice loads of close-ups there, so you can see.
You get extra bands with it, by the way.
Do you know how much
it
is, roughly?
I don't.
He was doing a special price at
Blackpool. He was doing
Blackpool,
a special price at Blackpool,
but you can get it from Murphy's Magic Dealers or Magic and Mentalism Store directly from Bondley to support the creator. Just a little bit of feedback from the other shows as well. Jamie Allen said to say thank you so much for all his support. He did sell quite a few books last week.
Mm-hmm.
And he asked me to pass on his thanks to everybody that has ordered his book. It is an amazing book. And I wanted to mention something as well, which I saw quite a few people in the comments. When I did the Magic Money, where I produced the... banknote from my phone with the new app from Magi Factory. And a lot of people saying you can't do that with polymer notes. And what I was telling people, I did put comments on YouTube, is if you do take an English banknote, you fold it and leave it in your wallet behind your cards, and that is inside there. Got my full set there, by the way.
Yeah.
Full set of cards.
Oh,
look,
you're carrying full set, are you?
If you leave that in there, it will, without any glue, without anything, it will just go to the right size. So I just wanted to let you know that a lot of people seem to be commenting, going, you can't do that with English notes. Well, you can, you just fold it. And when it's been folded for a certain amount of time, it just keeps that shape, and I keep it behind.
So I didn't know that it would hold the shape like that, and it really does.
I don't think a lot of people did, because it was on YouTube, and a lot of people were saying, but you can't do it with those notes. But if you just fold it and leave it for a few days, it's ready. And now we've got the close-up camera in view, we can talk about this, which is Cat Burglar, HANSON CHIEN Productions.
Mm.
So... what do you think to this? Can you go through what it actually is, Sean?
Well, it's the little hand routine.
Yes. Farmer.
But however, what makes it a bit interesting, it's a bit like that toy that's the cat with the hand that goes like that, the lucky money thing.
Yeah.
And you get the lucky coin that you put on your hand, and the cat's paw comes out and steals it, and then disappears. What's great about this version, and I'm not going to go into a method, but it allows for a completely clean vanish without any particularly difficult moves.
It's difficult at this angle to perform it on the Wizard Magic Review. We'll put some clips on the screen. We all had a go at it during the breakfast this morning. Yeah. Wayne discovered that you enjoyed using your little finger and actually more of a range of motion. Yeah. So if you know how it works and you know what we're talking about, that should make sense to you. They do talk about on the tutorial as well, we've not done that with this one here, that you take your gimmick and actually with pencil draw on these bits and define the feet a bit more. it does make a bit of a difference. Yeah. But as Sean was saying, in Japanese culture, I think it might be Chinese, but I know in Japan.
I think it's China, because my friend Harry, like that owns the Chinese restaurant in town, Maxi Buffet, he's got them all over the place.
And this is like a traditional coin. I don't think we understand it as much in this part of the world, but they have these lucky coins. I don't think they pick up on that in England, but you can just use a steel-based coin for this. But as Sean said, the key difference with this version is not only that you're referring to the cat burglar, is the fact that it's a cat's paw rather than a hand.
Yes.
Because you've got the, what's his name? I've forgotten his name. That does the pregnant woman.
He goes and
Infinity, Mark Infinity.
Go to the pregnant ladies and makes the baby.
Makes a little hand come out of the stomach. And I think he does it with a black hand as well when it's white women and that kind of thing. He's also got a black version of something else, but we'll not go into that. I'm sure somebody will let you know in the comments. But as Sean said, as well as all the routines they discuss, there's one with a selfie of a cat and you see the paw come from behind the phone. Didn't really like that. There's different versions where you use just a sleight of hand version. And there's the one with the gimmick that works really well.
Yeah.
And that gimmick is in the box as well. And as Sean said, that allows for the complete vanish.
Yeah, completely clean.
Wayne, what did you think of it and what's your mark?
Again, I thought it was a lot of fun. These kind of things are always shocking for people, so it's extreme close up. I think this has got a lot of legs.
Let me just pause for a minute.
Pause for it.
Whilst we just pull back to our memories. What you just
don't get catty.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give this 80%.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm not going to do it. I think it's great. It's not. It has brought a couple of new things. 73% from me.
73. You do get more on the little
finger.
You do.
Little fingers better.
You get more action. Whoa, look at that.
Action on the little finger.
Sean has got an X-rated script that we're not going to go into in the show.
Yeah.
How much did you give it?
I gave it 73%.
I'm going to give it 81%. It's made very well. The real secret to it is a nice little addition as well, allowing for that complete vanish. It's available in ginger and... I'm just doing the review!
Orange. It says orange.
It's ginger and grey. It's available in both. You need to choose your preference.
I prefer ginger.
From HANSON CHIEN Products. Production. At the time of this show coming out, you'll have been in Sheffield.
Yeah.
Doing your lecture.
Lecturing at Sheffield.
I'll have been in Manchester two nights ago, but the show will have been out. So, but have you got lectures coming up after next Wednesday?
Yeah, I'm doing Leicester as well.
Leicester.
I can't remember what day it is. I've got Sheffield, Leicester, and I'm looking like I'm going down to Kent at some point as well.
I'm going to Middlesbrough and Nottingham I've got coming up. I'll try and put a Facebook post out on the same day. You?
And I will be at comedy clubs all over the country. Tomorrow I'm in Leek, but I've already done that at the Fox Arts Centre and then many more. But what's going on here?
I'm just giving the deck a casual shuffle.
Why are you doing that, Dave?
You know, like you do.
Absolutely.
I'm going to do... a piece of magic.
Magic?
Are you ready?
I love magic.
Wayne, I'm going to do this on you. So, first of all, can you cut off about half the cards?
Okay, no.
Cut off about half. That's it. To there. And then this is what I want you to do. Just mirror me. You're going to count off the top of the deck 10 cards like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10.
Right, okay. And then flip all these cards over.
Right.
And I've seen that card there, so I don't want you to see these. But what I don't want to see them. But what I want you to do, spread the cards out like this.
All right.
And then just spread them towards yourself, like that.
Okay.
And just you could put the face down cards down. Just keep the face up ones towards you. right? And just look at those cards in that fan. Okay. And I want you to remember one of those cards. Don't, I saw the ace, so don't pick that. Right. Maybe don't get a picture card.
I've got one.
But just think of one of those cards.
All right, I've got one.
Okay. Square up the cards again.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then what I want you to do, just put the cards down like this. Put the cards down. And you are thinking of one of those cards, right? Yeah. You are thinking of one of those cards. For the first time, tell me the card that you're thinking about.
The Two of Hearts.
The Two of Hearts.
Yeah.
And you counted those cards, right?
I counted them out, yeah.
Just here. How many cards did you have before?
10.
10. Just here, just count into one pile how many cards you've got. You can deal.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's lovely.
And I didn't touch those cards. And look, this is the crazy thing. If I spread the cards, there's your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 cards. Oh. And you saw the Two of Hearts,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
It's not there.
Mate, that's lovely.
And I didn't touch the cards. And look.
Oh, God, man. No.
Shut the front door and call me Susan. The Two of Hearts. It is so good. I really love this.
There you go. So this is by an original concept by Geron Clark and additional sort of subtleties and ideas by Christian Grace. It's a great tutorial. They go through two or three sort of different methods. Mm-hmm. You might have a slightly different outcome depending on how you perform it.
Yep.
But what I liked about it, you get the specially gimmick cards with it to do the effect. They needed to be added to a deck in use, and you can just go in and use it during a normal sort of card routine. But on the tutorial, they go through so many different versions, as well as talking about Geron's sort of beginnings with the effect. They then progress onto versions that Christian goes into using just normal cards that you could do with a deck in use. I actually really prefer this super clean version that uses these gimmick cards, which means this subtlety, this method that Geron's come up with, means that in the action of the spectator counting the cards, they perform the trick on themselves and they vanish the cards.
It is incredible.
They vanish the card that they're thinking
very,
of.
Very clever thinking.
It's the princess card trick has always been a classic of magic, hasn't it? But now, incorporating that principle into any thought of card to pocket, and the reason I'm going like this, that's what it's called, pocket, but it can be anywhere.
It can.
It can be under a tablecloth, it can be under a mat, it could be in this pocket, in that pocket. It could be on the spectator, technically,
if
it was the right outcome.
You feel guilty performing it because you're not doing anything. It's incredible. It's that good.
That feeling...
when you've counted
them. When I've counted them out like this, and I've performed it as, you know, feeling as a layperson, counting them out, I really did have to sit back and think, what has just happened there?
Yeah.
I genuinely had to really think hard. But yeah, very, very clever thinking.
Yeah, really, really good. I'm really impressed with this. There's not a lot more to say. It comes with everything you need. The gimmick cards, you need to add them to a deck that you've already got. But all the gimmick cards you've got, so you can cleanly affect that vanish in the spectator's hands, and they do everything themselves. Everything's in the packet to achieve that. It's Any Thought of Card to Pocket. It's exclusive to Illusionist by Geron Clark and Christian Grace. I'm giving this 95%. I think it's excellent.
I'm giving it 100%. I think it's brilliant.
You need to do it on somebody,
don't you? I'm going to do it on somebody. I can't wait to do it on somebody.
I have to tell you as well, I'm getting this. I am going to also give it 100%.
Oh.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
Yeah, it's really, brilliant. Really good thinking. Illusionists have sent a few things in for review. They're making their way up to the top of the review pile. There's a couple more items. Another one from Christian, actually, that's on its way to the review table. And don't forget, if you want to see something reviewed on the Wizard Magic Review, you can email info@worldmagicshop.com or sales@worldmagicshop.com. That'll come through to the team directly, or message me on Facebook if we're already Facebook friends. I don't accept people on Facebook. If I haven't met you, I'm sorry, we have to meet in person, or I have to absolutely know that I know you to accept a friend's request. Is that what you do these days?
No, I don't.
I don't have that type of account anymore.
No, you've got a blue tick to count. Let's all talk about Sean's blue tick.
Bam.
Come on. Congratulations.
Yeah, well done.
Well done.
Well done.
I believe that. So that is it for this week's Wizard Magic Review from humble magicians like myself and Wayne Fox and the newly crowned blue tick celebrity card trick king Sean Heydon. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
We'll see you next time on the Wizard Magic Review.